glad she got a Lord son. That eliminates a lot.
Thank you.
had it right on it about it. Well, one person, what's going on, my brother, sister, love you all. I just know this motherfucker who loves you. Really.
Last step but not least, we're gonna just go around everything, play everything real good. I take my clay on my knee, my clay breaker just getting to another swing side. Also want to keep a good grip on this clay, because if you drop it, you really ain't supposed to use it no more. Really not supposed to use it, but. Oh, almost broke my ear. Bring y'all down to the next time, the dope time. Watch and learn. We hang. You better have them. permanent, I'm gonna play that bottom last. So it's always the dirtiest. So I'm gonna do that part last on both sides. Guy asked me today on Instagram, what does clay do? What is it for? What's the reason for it? I just told him, you know, it just pulls out the dirt that a regular car wash won't get off, and embedded contaminants and whatnot. He was like, okay. Some people, just as simple as that. Tell them one time they got it. But like I say, everything we do is elementary. Everything. You don't need a degree to do nothing we do. No kind of certification, none of that. Made to the back over here. We're gonna go around here on this side. We're gonna go around here. We're gonna meet at the back right there. And that'll be the place out there. See how much shit grind up over here? I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna do right there. One second, I'll show you right now. Like I say, it ain't nothing about this shit rocket science. I need my soap down here. Okay. Okay, I got my lube. I'm good. If you're tall, use your body, use your length. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to be sitting here doing this right here. Use your body. You know what I'm saying? That way, you can go on and get through with things. It ain't going to sacrifice your quality. You know? But if you're tall, you kind of got a benefit over others. It ain't that bad. If y'all can pick and focus in on that. Y'all see that? It ain't that bad. But it still gotta be done. as I sprayed it, I always clay my bottom last because that's where the dirt is at. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to bring none of that back up toward the top of the car, period. So I always clay the bottom last. And I also clay my mirrors too. I had to get the little excess little bugs or whatnot off there. Every time you hear anything, you need to stop. You need to clay. That's a piece of grit, a dirt. And if you keep going, you're gonna be mad at yourself. As soon as you hear it, you need to stop. And you will know, you'll hear it. It'll sound like a little light scratching. We're going to hit this front right quick. Then we're going to rinse off, dry off, inspect the paint. Let's see where we're going to go. Got a new system I'm using this time. I normally use Pericola. Compounds when I do protection work. I normally use this here for regular 1 and 2, then the fine compound polishing. This is what I normally use, but I'm going to try something different this time. I'm the type of person, I like to deal with the innovators, people who started something, people who ain't copying nobody, who did that first. And I'm speaking of 3M. So they got a three-step level 3 system, and that's what I'm going to try today on this one. I heard it worked pretty good. I knew 3M in the past. They are kind of expensive, but just like everybody said, it's the truth. You get what you pay for, you know? So I'm going to try and see what kind of results it's going to give me. Like I said, I need some more lubrication on down here, so I got the float right here. Okay, get down there. Get down there. Go down there. Down here. raining again. Bump over this fake ass chrome a little bit. Then we can bring it back to the luster that it was. Did she ask for this here? Nope, but hey. This is the kind of free stuff I do. I'm not going to do no free work, but I give an extra bump, you know, if I see something that can enhance my quality of job to present it to a customer, especially if they're a first time, you want to really impress them with your work. Yeah, do a little something extra in there. Don't go nowhere doing nothing free, but you get this opportunity to work on somebody's car, and you know, you can tell somebody who will deal with you. So, do a little something extra. And that ain't gonna take you no long time, you know. All right. another thing too. You know how when you see people rinsing cars? They hit the car, they going out of here. Look, when you rinsing your car, man, all you need to do is do this. You want stuff to come down. You're throwing all this, you're throwing soap everywhere, back over the car, you're really wasting time. Just hold your arm up in there, it might hurt your arm a little bit for a little while. Get your arm up in there so all the stuff will run down. I see a lot of people doing it, they're just coming in the car. They just throwing the soap everywhere. You know, just hold your arm up and just rinse everything to the bottom. One more little tip. To say, for instance, to say the pump light on your pressure washer, if you have an issue with having to buy pressure washers like every year, every other year, when you crank the pressure washer up, you need to be pulling your trick on your lens. That way you can be releasing the pressure if any is built up in the pressure washer. And when you're cranking it, you need to also have your trigger pulled. If you don't, that pressure built up in that pump and you steadily try and pull, that's why when you pull it sometimes and it feel like it's hard, it's because it's built up with pressure. If you pull that trigger, it'll crank right up. there? No, I don't. I just ain't no rush. This job ain't got to be done this Saturday, so y'all see how I do. I do sanding, tiles, I blow dry some more. I just got to do 11-3 on this. The less I can put in it, the less I want to put in it. As far as marring and scratching and stuff like that.